sex offender should be made public by me, Amy Bailey. And my introduction and thesis is, how would you feel if you didn't know that you were living next to a registered sex offender?
Bad.
You can get on the list for various reasons, such as child pornography, visiting a prostitute, being in public, or even flashing somebody. And the thesis is, sex offenders should be made public. So there are different levels of being a sex offender. It's high risk, medium risk, and low risk. At high risk, you have a high risk of repeating the offense and you're a threat to public safety. A medium risk is that you have a moderate risk for repeating the offense, and a low risk is you have low risk of repeating the offense. So my opposition is, being labeled as a sex offender, after you get jail time or probation, you are given restrictions on everything you do. So after your sentence or probation, your name, photographs and addresses are put online to the public. Basically everything about you is put online, and ours is the Texas Department of Safety. And America's sex offender laws are the strictest in any democracy, and that's basically saying that the United States are so strict that they'll never basically have a normal life again. So, on this one, this quote is by someone who was drunk and had public nudity, and they said, "I have never even touched anyone. Somebody like me doesn't deserve to be on that list, but it isn't okay for somebody who actually touched a child." Over the thousands and thousands of people on that list, a very small portion of them are actually seriously harmful sex offenders. So here's my part on why sex offenders should be made public. Okay. So I have a quote, and it says, one woman explained how she had been brutally beaten, knifed, and raped, and she said now that she sleeps with a pistol underneath her pillow, which is not safe. And that's by Schneider on page 658, paragraph 8. And it's basically that she has to deal with this the rest of her life. She has to, you cannot just go every day without not thinking about it. It's just a terrible thing that people have to go through. And so my next one is, people in the community need to know. Residency laws restrict registered sex offenders from living within a certain number of feet from schools, daycares, and churches. This is also known as Jessica's Law. When this law was passed, over 2,700 offenders moved, and some even left homeless. Giving the public notice about offenders gives parents a chance to look and see if there are any living in the area that they want to raise their child in. Some offenders are even banned from living in a certain community. I know that in Florida, there are communities where if you were even on a list, that you're not even allowed to live in that community. And this is kind of weird, but my mom actually checks the sex offender list every month. Once a month, and there's a high-risk guy that actually lives in White Right, and she claims that she has seen him before, and she tells him about it, she loves to talk about it. And if somebody committed this crime, it created fear within the community. A woman said that a guy playing with her children, and he was a close friend of the family, and I told her that she needed to check it out for the safety of her children, and she did learn that the creep was indeed a sexual predator. This quote basically just explains why the names and photographs need to be out to the public, because the woman would have never known that a creep was playing with her kids. Like, so, in conclusion, do you really think that sex offenders should be made public? And so they make a horrible decision, and they have to live with it for the rest of their life. And it can damage a community and harm a person mentally and physically. And you can contact me at my Gmail and Twitter. And that's the end of it.